Ooch, I just got hit up. Someone wants to buy a pair of my undies. How much for your undies? How much you got? He won't reply straight away because he's not online, but might be a cheeky $400-$500.
There's nothing quite like having someone pay you money to spend time with them.
I suppose my whole life I've had to go against what I've been told is socially acceptable and what's not.
How did I get into a position where I could just do this as a job and get paid for it?
I got into sex work. It was kind of out on a whim, I guess. I think it was my dad brought up on Christmas that, you know, like, if he had a body like mine, he'd exploit it and make money. And I kind of had the idea, I was just like, fuck, I'll just sell pics and, you know, make easy cash. I think he was more, like, thinking underwear modelling. But, you know, basically the same thing. I'm getting my chores out of the way too today. Hashtag ADHD. What other people think, I do not care, because it doesn't have anything to do with me. Because if it's making me money and it's safe and I'm doing it professionally, then I don't see a problem with it. It's kind of like a stigma, I guess. People kind of look at the industry that I'm in, you know, and judge it like it's a kind of evil thing. I mean, I don't know. People my age are a lot more, say, woke to the idea of sex work and, you know, things like that. But I find the older generation is a little bit, I mean, unless they've grown up around that stuff, they're a little bit less understanding about that. So I only, you know, talk about it to certain people.
I feel like a little fucking sex superhero. Like, no one around me or no one that I know knows about me escorting or my sex work. I got into sex work because I was financially struggling. As someone suggested to me, like, wow, you would be a great escort. Like, you have such good communication skills. You know how to talk to people. You should go escort women and take them on dates, blah, blah, blah. And I took that quite literally. And I applied to a couple of websites and started getting clients. I can go and escort after uni, I can go and escort after one of my jobs or my second job. I can do it anytime, you know? Not gonna lie, I'm pretty uninterested. I'm there for the money.
The client before? Oh, great. Yeah, really good. Yeah. No, easy. You know, I enjoy my work. I love my work. You know, so it's not like work. It's like getting paid for doing something you enjoy. You know, so I love that. So I'm just going to get rid of all my sex work stuff. Get rid of the condoms and lube. Pictures back on the wall. When I worked in my youth, it was pre-internet days, so you didn't have the scope to be working independently so much. Street-based work was your only option. Back in those days, a lot of the work was, you know, oral sex and hand jobs. You very rarely had full sex, but then, you know, a lot of them was fast and quick and in cars and, you know, back alleyways, which has totally changed now to today's time. I prefer my work during the day, especially now. In my young days, all my work was at night, you know, and everything was about nighttime. But now as a more mature person, I was like, you know, I want my work during the daytime. I want my evenings free. I don't want to be working at nighttime.
I got into sex work at a relatively young age. Definitely, looking back, too young, but, you know, it was never talked about. I never knew any of the the dangers or anything to worry about. So at that age, there was no real reason for me not to, as far as I was aware. It wasn't until after I'd started having sex that I realized that sex doesn't have to be a meaningful thing. It can just be something you do for fun. So it made it a lot easier to then transition into sex work, because I was like, oh, well, these guys will pay me to just do something that I'm like either don't care about or will have fun with. The only meaning behind it is what we decide to put on it. There's no set meaning that everything has to have. I've never really mentioned this side of my life to my family, because it's so hard to talk to anyone unless you know already that they're going to be all right with it. Because, you know, I've had people who I thought would be good friends, and then I've told them about sex work and they've completely disappeared out of my life, because the stereotypes that surround sex work paint it in such a negative light that they wouldn't acknowledge that sex work is fine, that, you know, I'm perfectly happy and safe and healthy doing it, and there's nothing that's inherently wrong with that.
The idea that somebody could pay you enough money to not say no to anything is terrifying. Because if you need money, there is, for most people, almost always somebody willing to pay you for sex. World's oldest profession. So the accessibility to people who are desperate leads to a lot of dangerous situations. For anyone who was saying, oh, you could do anything, why are you doing this? I started making money from sex work out of necessity when I was younger than you're really supposed to. And it kind of just turned into something I always come back to for extra money now that I don't need to do it, because at least for me, it's a fun side hustle.
Sex work, it's definitely not something that I would have considered doing as a job or a future career. When like that young, you'd still almost think it's taboo or would like feel wrong to do. Yeah, it definitely wasn't a snap decision that, okay, I'm going to get into this line of work. A lot of it's intertwined in one way or connected to another. Example, I started to do a few nude life drawing classes, doing the modelling, and then stripping, sensual massage. I think it was more so a gradual slope of, okay, I'm going to do this. I do have a normal day job, the old 9-to-5, which can make things a little bit hard, obviously, to try and balance everything in the meantime. Yeah, sex work is definitely a lot more labour intensive, emotionally. Having to connect and be present can be exhausting, like very mentally draining, but it's just something that you learn to do after a while.
For so long I've been telling people that my dream job was to be a porn star, and like, you know, I'd always been very intrigued, and I knew I liked sex, and I was like, well, why could I not make money off it? I think working in the industry, for someone like me now looking back, was hard because of the fact that I probably get more enjoyment out of sex when I have a connection with someone. You know, my idea of what enjoyable sex is for me did play a wee bit into the reason why I eventually stopped. I think the big thing with my family is that they love me. They're worried about me. They want me to be safe. And because there is such a misconception that people who work in sex work are being abused, are being trafficked, are being taken advantage of, that is immediately the thing that I know that they would jump to of the, you know, me, if I sat down and sit to them like, hey guys, that's what I did. It'd be the, oh my God, we've failed our son so much that he had to go and do this. Like, they had to go work in sex work. Me doing sex work, people doing sex work. We're not damaged, we're not broken, we're not, something isn't wrong with us. And I think that's that what a lot of people don't understand, and what I think I would expect my parents to understand, is how someone could choose this option.
Keep your head, everyone's still.